So I'm just outside one of the junior high schools where I work in central Japan. And right now we are under an official state of emergency. But schools are still allowed to operate within a certain set of guidelines. Yeah, I'm really curious as to how things are going to look. What does pandemic state of emergency education look like in central Japan? It should be interesting. Let's go in and check it out. This state of emergency? Well, basically it's lockdown light. Prefectures that have a high infection rate have certain restrictions imposed, but limitations on individual behavior are suggested rather than enforced. So, non-essential publicly run facilities are closed, as are establishments that primarily serve alcohol. Other businesses, including restaurants, stay open, but have to limit their hours of operation to close by 8 p.m. And a few other suggestions as well. Generally speaking, schools are to stay open, but take various risk management countermeasures, including shifting operations online as much as possible. For universities, this is generally 100%. For high schools, I've heard there's a pretty big range, depending on the area and the individual school. I work in elementary schools and junior high schools, like this one. So, what's the situation here? Let's take a look. As usual, I arrive at school a little before 8:30. Write my temperature on the health check condition reporting sheet. Read the daily briefing. As expected, the kids are here for morning classes only. And what's this? A CO2 monitor? Well, that's new. Apparently, each classroom gets one to monitor the air quality, basically to make sure we keep the air moving through. First period class is starting soon. Let's see what's going on in the classrooms. As I mentioned before, the guidelines limit the amount of close face-to-face interaction between students. Now, group work is a really important part of education in Japan. So how can we manage this while still following the guidelines? One of the ways is by using tablets in class. Getting a tablet PC into the hands of each student is a national educational priority. And in my area, at least, it seems to have been achieved. Right now, students are using a collaborative presentation and idea visualization application. Students can show each other their ideas rather than explaining them verbally. At the end of the class, they digitally submit their work to the teacher, and later, when they log in again at home, new tasks will be available to them. There has been a bit of a learning curve, but training workshops offered by the city, as well as great cooperation among teachers at individual schools, has gone a long way to get everyone on the same page. And when teachers do have troubles in class, the kids usually come to the rescue. English classes have been challenging. Classes with a foreign teacher, or ALT, are generally supposed to be active and communicative. But what about those limitations on activities like face-to-face interactions between students? I'm still trying to figure it all out. And then there's the fact that not all the students are physically in class right now. Some families have elected to keep their kids home from the morning, and in that case, they're usually participating via Zoom. This is more common in elementary school. I'll show you an example in a minute. Anyway, we're doing our best under the circumstances. Fourth period class is finished, and it's time for lunch. School lunch will be served, as usual, but with a few minor adjustments. For one thing, students are not permitted to talk to each other, and not all students will eat at school. Eating together is considered to be an activity with a high transmission risk, and families who are nervous about the situation have asked that their children come home before lunch. Actually, the decision whether or not to serve lunch at school during the state of emergency was not made lightly. Most people initially felt that it was a bad idea. In the end, though, the feeling of responsibility to ensure that all children can eat a nutritionally balanced lunch, and the fact that most of the ingredients had already been purchased in advance by lunch centers, proved to be the deciding factors. In the afternoon, students head home and either join officially scheduled Zoom lessons or do self-paced study with online materials provided by the school. Recording online materials is one of the things that I'll be doing this afternoon.
Let's start. Are you from Sydney? Are you a rugby fan? Do you like soccer?
Don't worry, I'm not going to bore you with all 33 of the questions. This is from a question and answer set that our 7th grade students have been practicing as a kind of warm-up drill at the beginning of each class, in pairs. But since pair work isn't really a thing right now, they get to practice with me at home. Well, we're hoping they do. Enough of that. Right now I'm busy checking videos of students' readings from a story in the textbook. 7th grade. The situation is similar at the elementary schools where I work, with a few differences. For one thing, both morning and afternoon classes take place more or less according to the usual schedule. The big difference being that they don't necessarily take place in a face-to-face format. Notice I said don't necessarily. This relates to the second difference from junior high school classes, and that's flexibility to accommodate different family situations and preferences. In the morning, for example, we conduct classes as usual. Well, minding the state of emergency guidelines, of course. But we also set up an iPad with an open Zoom link for those students who aren't comfortable physically attending class. So quiet. I have to admit, I find this part a bit depressing. Kids are supposed to make noise. Well, at least they seem to be out having fun for a PE class. Albeit in a fairly controlled manner. Masks are optional outside, by the way, but most kids seem to keep them on anyway. Lunchtime. Some of the kids stay for lunch, and some go home. Most stay, though. And afterwards, kids who have a parent or guardian at home, or nearby, go home and get ready to join afternoon classes via Zoom. Kids who don't have a safe situation to go home to stay at school. Because of this situation, lesson content generally has to be simplified a bit, or at least adjusted to allow multiple modes of participation. I personally found it pretty strange looking back and forth between a tablet screen and real-life students the whole time. Well, I think I'm starting to get used to it.
How many melons? So you check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, good. One more time. How many melons?
Eight
melons.
You look tired.
I'm very, very tired.
TGIF.
Oh, hey. Let's move this over so I don't spill it. Well, it's Friday night. the end of a long and really interesting week at work. Considering the chaotic and less than ideal situation right now, I'm really impressed by how all the teachers have been handling everything. I mean, just a couple of years ago, I couldn't have imagined my coworkers using so much technology in the classroom. Well, it isn't really even the technology. What's really impressive to me is how everyone has managed such a big shift in the style of education in such a short time. Believe it or not, the education system here is quite resistant to change. In the almost 20 years I've been working in schools here, I've heard lots of talk about future education and applying the latest research and techno innovation, blah, blah, blah. But nothing really ever actually changes. But then the schools shut down last year and everyone pulled together and made a plan to make sure it didn't happen again with the help of a little public money for the tablets, etc. And here we are in 2021, another state of emergency. And this time, we're ready for it. Mostly. Well, thanks for watching. If you're interested in seeing more videos about schools and education in Japan, let me know in the comments. And for those of you who've been following my home construction adventure series, yes, this is our new place. Construction's finished and we've moved in. And no, I'm not giving you a tour yet. But yes, I'll have the next video up for you shortly. それじゃあ、乾杯!